Two.
Don't me in, Mr. Van. Are you ready?
Good morning. Good morning, world. Good morning, Bahamas. Good morning, Grand Bahama. It is such a privilege and a pleasure to be here in the nation's second city, Freeport, Grand Bahama, to be exact. And we are coming to you live. Yes, this is the National Arts Festival. It's officially called the E. Clement Bethel Festival. It's been going on for about 50 years now and still pushing through. So we're so happy, excited to be back in person. And the Ministry of Youth, Sports, and Culture has the responsibility of bringing this festival to the nation every year. And this year is no exception, but again, back in person. We are so excited to have our adjudicator with us today in the person of Mr. Ricardo Christie. He comes very well qualified. Those of you who are here, come on, put your hands together for our adjudicator. He's been dancing for many, many years. He's from the beautiful island of New Providence. And he's been throughout the length and breadth of the Bahamas and also the world, sharing his talent, teaching, and also performing. He is a professional dancer, and so again, he comes well qualified. I'm so happy to have the Assistant Director of Culture with us today. Her name is Mrs. Portia Sands. Would you put your hands together for the Assistant Director? Oh, on the ground with us. And again, my name is Therese. I am the Cultural Affairs Officer for Drama. And so we are happy. Behind the camera, our technical expert this afternoon or this morning is Mr. Antoine Francis. And we appreciate his work all the time. All right? So are you ready, dancers?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh! We are ready to begin. So without any further ado, ladies and gentlemen, we present to you the dance adjudication for the E. Clement Bethel Festival continuation.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Nixon. We're going to begin our adjudications this morning with Leslie Lewis, Jack Haywood Jr. with a liturgical dance. Leslie Lewis.
Just so you know, I'm going to ring a bell, and when I ring that bell, you will introduce yourself, and then you can begin your presentation, okay? So just remember to wait for the bell, please.
Okay.
Good morning. My name is Leslie Lewis. I attend Jack Haywood Junior High School, and I will be dancing Speak the Name.
Thank you.
The atmosphere is changing. Nothing stays the same. Heaven is waiting for the mention of a name. The spirit is moving, burning like a flame. Healing, broken by the one we proclaim. Mountains move, we lift them high.
So what we will do is we will let everybody perform, and then I will do some notes after that. So right now we have what, 3 or 4 groups. So after the 4 groups, then we will hear some comments. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Leslie. We will now call the group Bohemian Folk Dance, St. Mary Patricia Russell.
Jump on the mountain, people, this one is just for you. I want you to feel that rhythm.
Thank you, ladies.
Thank you very much. We want to call now from Sister Mary Patricia Russell, Sarah Roker,
Jesus.
Let your glory fill this place. Let your consuming fire fill this tabernacle and purify our hearts. Wants us to breathe new life within us. Send a refreshing love. Purify our hearts.
Let your glory fill this
place. Let your all-consuming fire.
Surround us in this place.
Breathe new life.
Thank you very much, Sarah. We invite now Selena McIntosh, also from Sister Mary Patricia Russell, with a solo liturgical dance.
So let's just, you know, because we're all dancers, just center yourself across the stage so that we have an even viewing thing. All right, so I want to say, ladies, good job, very good job today. I like what you all presented. I can see that you rehearsed and you worked hard so that you can present your craft in its best light. And I appreciate that. It's very important as dancers or performers that we put the time in for rehearsals, because you don't ever want to sell yourself short whenever you're, you know, portraying your talent. I want to start with the group, the folk group dance. Very good energy. It looked as though you all got comfortable at the end. The nerves got you at the beginning, and at the end you were ready to do more. I got really engaged at the end. So all I want to say is, you have to start strong and finish strong. Because when I saw you doing all your line formations and all of this beautiful choreography, at the end I'm like, oh, you know, but I didn't see that in the beginning. It wasn't a bad thing, but you need to make sure that you are at that high level at the very beginning and you finish the same way. I love your line formations. Your choreographer should be commended. It was never a dull moment. There was movement around the stage, and even when you moved in these different positions, you all were still doing the choreography together, and it was clean. My biggest thing, though, you have these faces that don't look like you're feeling the rhythm, you know? And I think you have to remember that, because I don't know whether it's shyness, because I'm sure when all of you go outside, you all become different people, wild and loud and all this, okay? So you have to know how to channel that energy into your performance, and don't be afraid of it. I see a lot of timidness, and you can't be timid as a dancer, because you have to appreciate your God-given talent, and you have to show it, because that's what you have to do. I want to make special mention for you, young lady, you are in the center. I don't know, are you the leader? Did you choreograph this? So they just put you in the center. But you all need to watch her. She captivates everybody with the eyes and the face, and all of that is very important, okay? So you have to learn from each other. It doesn't make anybody better, but you always have to look at other people and say, okay, let me see how I can do that, and then make that my own, okay? That's what it is, it's sharing. But anyway, good job. I will share your scores with your, actually, I will tell you, I gave you a 94. Moving on, St. Mary, Patricia. No, sorry. Leslie, let me go to Leslie, Jack Hayward. Very good. I want to say this, Miss Leslie. Were you chewing gum? Yeah, you can't do that. And I'll tell you why. Not only is it very dangerous, because if you're dancing and you're breathing, if that gum goes down the wrong windpipe, you could choke. So it's not only bad for you as a performer, but also it's just not professional. But however, I did like the fact that you were your energy and your turns and your movement was very good. You committed to the song, and I can see that you had connected to it as well. But I want to say this too to all the liturgical dancers, before I say anything else with Miss Lewis. It is your duty as a liturgical dancer, especially if you choose that medium. It's a form of worship. And if you're going to choose that to say, this is how I want to worship, you have to realize that you have to help people, okay? You have to invoke this feeling. And if it doesn't come through your face and your body and in your emotions, then you're not doing that form of worship justice. So I just want you to know that whenever you do liturgical dancing, yes, it is dance, and dance is an art form, you have to be committed. You have to show that you are feeling what the song is saying through your body and through your face, okay? So just, I know you're young, and this is probably something you will understand as you mature, but there's nothing wrong with starting early. You have to connect with your songs and show it through your face especially. But anyway, Ms. Lewis, good job. I want you to continue. You do dance training at all? Some? You should probably do some dance training, because I can see some technique in there, and it would be lovely if you can incorporate some technical dance moves in your choreography, because what that also does, it helps you to expand and not repeat the same steps over and over again. So, good job. I would like to see more of you, and hopefully in a dance class somewhere. I gave you 86. Good job. St. Mary, Patricia. come on, it really works because you incorporated like some kicks and some leg movements. So when you do the leg movement, there's an illusion or there's another visual nice thing that we can see. So I appreciate that. Like, do you do dance class as well somewhere?
No, sir.
No? Well, you all should because I see some really raw talent and I would like to see how you can foster that. Like I said to Ms. Lewis, if you have training or dance training, it can help you to find more steps. And I think that's what a lot of the liturgical stuff I've seen so far has been struggling with. Like, the song is so long, and how do I fill this song with steps? So, you know, you just have to use your creativity, and the more you feel things, you will be invoked to do more things with your body. So, good job as well. Let me see, I said everything I said. Very good use of stage. Beautiful question. I gave you an 88. Good job. And lastly, Miss Selena McIntosh. Excuse me, pardon me. Selena McIntosh, I have here amazing lines. And you're almost like ready for, well, you're not almost ready, but I could see how if you were to dance and train, there's no reason why you couldn't audition for Alvin Ailey. You don't know who that is. He's a very, very popular, it's a very, very popular dance company in the United States. And you have a natural, your body is naturally moving like most of those dancers. So are you in a dance class? You all need to get in a dance class. All of you. I know it's after a whole bunch of stuff with the pandemic and the storms and this thing and that thing, but take it from me. It's never too late, and you all have the raw talent, and I think you all are doing an amazing job. But back to you, Ms. Patricia. Nice lines, very good use of the technical elements, even if you don't even have that much technique. Whatever you have naturally came through, and I appreciate that. So, good use of stage, and everything was just beautiful. Just tend to stay away from the black. Stay away from black costuming, especially for the liturgical stuff, unless it's something characterize, you know, you always want to be light, because again, it's spiritual and, you know, dark, unless it's for a theme, I would like to see something more light and lively. But you did a good job, and I gave you a 94. All right, so again, please take all of my criticisms, they're constructive, but the most important thing I want to say is, I guess for everybody in the room and in Grand Bahama, let's really see if we can get some dance classes. I know there's a few dance schools here, so find a dance school, find a dance teacher, because you don't want this talent to go to waste. I traveled the world and I got an education because of dance. So even if you want to be a doctor, you can still do it, dance and get a dance scholarship or something. Don't ever think that you always just have to be a performer somewhere. You can use it for many, many reasons, and it can help you. And they say dancers are the smartest people, so, yeah. All right, thank you, ladies. Have a good day. One second.
Okay, I just wanted to make a suggestion or a recommendation. Specifically for the liturgical dancers, I know some of you probably dance in church, and you would use scarves, you would use small flags, you would use small articles. And I think when you performed today, that in those areas where the music intensified, you needed to add a little something more just to build the intensity. And so just small articles, nothing distracting, okay? Just small articles that could intensify your movement and your expression to engage the adjudicator or the audience. I think those would be acceptable, okay? Thank you so much.
Well, this has been a wonderful and exciting morning, and we want to thank all of you for coming. And those of you who've been watching us live, Thank you so much. And we just want to let you know that there are still some adjudications going on. We're going to take a short break now, but there are some adjudications going on at the C.A. Smith building. There we go. So the C.A. Smith building, as well as the Church of the Ascension, and a couple other spots. So please check us out on our Facebook page, which is Ecom and Bethel. There you go. Thank you, everybody. This is Therese signing off. We'll see you soon.